Your policy towards South Africa has been largely dominated by a single-minded pursuit of economic and strategic considerations. This, in my view, can be, at best, only on a temporary advantage. For in the final analysis, only a South Africa which accepts a majority rule can truly offer a lasting guarantee to the security of your economic and strategic interests. I have a vision, Mr. Chairman, of a great South African community in which the rights of all are protected. Such a vision of justice, concord and progress in the interests of mankind cannot come about so long as Pretoria continues with impunity to violate international law and the fundamental rights of man. Those who deceive themselves in the delusion that most vile atrocities against man can be perpetrated behind the fence of arms must recognize that the limits of tyranny have throughout history been prescribed by those who suffer the humiliation, degradation, and injustice meted out by the tyrant. All men of goodwill will have a responsibility to persuade Pretoria to return to the path of reason and justice. From the response reaching us, certain powers are currently engaged in assisting the government in Pretoria to acquire nuclear capability. As signatories to the nuclear non-proliferation arrangement, we condemn this action, which amounts to double standard. Likewise, we cannot support any attempt at arming the enemies of humanity with the means of nuclear blackmail. Under such conditions, it would be unreasonable to expect that all other non-nuclear nations will continue to deny themselves of this means of self-defense.